bifilar suspension. The aim of this experiment is to determine the radius of gyration of a body. Assume that a beam of some mass is suspended by two strings tied at the extreme ends such that the beam remains perfectly horizontal. Now, as the beam is uniform, its CG lies at the center of the body, or say at the midway, the distance between the two strings. The frequency of this system can be determined by equation 1 by 2 pi b by k root g by l. Here b is the distance of CG from either strings, k is radius of gyration, l is the length of suspension, and g is the gravitational constant, that is 9.81. Now, if we can measure the time period of this system, we can determine the radius of gyration from this above equation. So we'll perform the experiment and measure the time period of the system. We can determine the value of radius of gyration theoretically by equation root of area moment of inertia by area. So area moment of inertia for a rectangular beam is h into l cube, and area is hl. So this equation looks like root of hl cube by hl. Here h is the height of beam and l is the length of beam. The equation suggests that it is dimensionally independent. So for our case, this will remain constant throughout the calculations. Now suppose we add some weight to this beam and check the value of time period and hence the radius of gyration. Theoretically, the equation gets a little modified. So IT, that is the total moment of inertia of the system, and that can be given by inertia of beam plus inertia of weight added. So inertia of beam, it is given by mk square. Again, for weight, mk square, the value of k will be changing depending upon the weight added. So in our case, we'll be placing equal even weights on the beam so that both the sides of the initial CG position are balanced. So now this equation can be modified as mk square of beam plus mk square of mass into the number of mass, or say the number of weight added on the either side. So if you're adding two weights, this n will be equals to 2. And again, for this value of k for weight, it can be given by root of a square plus r square by 2. Ideally, it is given by r by 2 if that's a circular, or say circular cross section. Here we are adding it at some distance from the CG, so we'll have that value as a, that is the distance of weight from CG, and r is again the radius of the weight, and hence we'll get the value of IT. Now grossly for the system, we can write this IT is equals to m into k square, where m is the total mass, that is mass of beam plus mass of weight, and k is k effective, that is the effective radius of gyration. And by this equation, if we have calculated IT, we can get the effective radius of gyration from this equation. We'll compare this with the values obtained experimentally, and then we'll conclude accordingly. Now let's perform the experiment.
This is the apparatus for bifilar suspension. This is the beam of length 502 mm, and its width is 7 mm. We'll be performing an experiment to find the radius of gyration of this body. As said earlier, bifilar suspension is a body which is suspended by two strings, or it is suspended at two ends. So first of all, we'll suspend this, and the height of suspension, that is from this end to this end, is kept as 560 mm. You can measure it using the scale. So basically, it's like measuring from this end to this. Okay. There's a check that you need to verify that both the strings are at same length, so you can get more accurate result. Otherwise, you'll be adding some more parameters which will lead to ill results. Okay. So first of all, let this be in equilibrium, and then we'll give torsional vibration, and we'll measure time for 10 oscillations. See, in this case, the body is ideally subjected to have torsional motion along an axis which is constant, and it is passing through its CG, in this case it's wobbling. The axis is not stable. Okay, so this again adds to ill results. So we'll try two or three times so as we can reduce this error as much as possible. This is again wobbling. Yeah, now it's quite stable. Yet you can wait on for a few minutes so that the wobble is reduced. So to measure 10 oscillations, it is start and stop one oscillation, so on the either side. So if it is, if you view this from top view, it's like this. So you start from here, so this is 1, that is 2, that is 3, that is 4. So from start to the other end, from equilibrium, and then again to the start. So that is one oscillation. So we start this. Start. So this comes down 9.56, so that is 9.56 seconds. Now in order to reduce the error, see, we might be, while performing, we might make mistakes because there are human errors, okay. So you start and you stop, do not stop it on the exact time. So in order to reduce that error, we will be taking 3 or 4 readings of one distance. So that this is the first distance that we give. This is the first set of vibrations, and we'll take 3 more readings so as we can reduce the error of measuring time. So again we start. 1, 2, 3. Oops, sorry, I made a mistake. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. So this comes to 9.75 seconds. Now once more you can start. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. So this comes to 9.65 seconds. So average out the reading of these 3, and you can consider that as the time period for 10 oscillations of this setup, that is at length of 560 mm. Now in this case we do not have any extra weight added to the body, so there are certain cases where we need to add weight. So this is the kind of weight which we can add. It's around 125 grams. And clamp it on the edge. So along this body, if this is the center, you consider equal distance on both the sides. So for our setup, this distance, the center distance for these two holes, that is 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5. So if the CG lies here, not if, the CG actually lies here. So the distance from this to this is 0.07 meters, that is 79 mm. And this is double of that, that is 158. So we'll be clamping it at here and we'll measure the time. Actually we will not rotate this, we need to screw it from bottom, but there are certain limitations in the working world. So So now we have added this wave at equal length, that is 0.079 meters. Now we'll take the same readings again. Not the same, the same kind of readings. So when we add weight, there are high chances that you'll get more amount of photons. So if you reduce the amplitude of reflection, you'll be able to reduce the amount of power. So do take that into consideration. You'll get more accurate results by that. See now. Less reflection, less power. Start here with just these statements. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. So that comes to 7.8. For me, this is 7.8 seconds. Again, you can start. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. So now it is 8.2 seconds. Again, once more. 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. So this time it was 8.3 seconds. So this is an increase in cycle. We need to take one more reading. So this amounts to 8.01 seconds. So you can take average of the last three, that is 8.2, 8.3 and 8.01 seconds. Now similarly, what we can do, we can switch the weight to the other holes. So now here again, the same thing. Starting this again. Starting it again. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. So this was 9.89 seconds. Once more. 8, 9, 10. So this was 9.60 seconds. So you can average all these readings and you can get the result. So this experiment we performed at the height of, or say, the length of suspension was 0.56 meters. Now, you can perform similar experiment at two or three different heights, and then you can arrive to a conclusion, and you can determine the accurate radius of gyration of the body or the system, because in every different arrangements, the radius of gyration should be different or not.
Like,
that is your takeaway. You guys have to tell me, would the radius of gyration be different when there is different amount of weight at these two edges, at these two points, or say these two points. So case one is you have same amount of weight adjusted at the same length, so 0.079, if that is the distance from this center, you are having 100 grams here and you are having 100 grams here. Second case is you have 100 grams on this side and 120 grams on the other side. Now check if the radius of gyration would be changed or not, or would the system be stable, or is this the right method to find the radius of gyration. So that is the task.
Now talking about the observation and result table, we have performed this experiment for length of suspension of 0.36 meters and 0.56 meters. In the result table, you can see the first row for both the readings is the case of no extra load added, and then the other two are based on the place of loading. That is, the first one is at 0.079, and the second one is at 0.158 meters from the center of the beam. Now we compare the values of radius of gyration theoretically and experimentally. You can see those titles in green. They are marked in dark, not dark green, but some other shade of green. In the purple color, we have 0.14 and 0.13. So they are of same orders. There is again a lighter shade of orange, where you can see the experimental value is 0.12 and that obtained theoretically is 0.20, and for the length of 0.56 it is 0.15 and 0.20. So they are grossly different. That is, the difference is 0.12 to 0.20, which is grossly different. So maybe there's a possibility of some error. In such cases, in order to verify this readings, we can recalculate it, and we have to again reperform the experiment. See, it's really efficient, because in both the cases we have got this difference. 0.20 remains constant for both of them, while 0.12 and 0.15, even they are of not the same orders. In the earlier reading, it is like 0.14 and 0.13. So 0.14 of 0.36 and 0.13 of 0.56 length. So they are quietly of near in range, while 0.12 and 0.15 are close to them. So there's something fishy here. We can reperform this experiment at the distance of 0.158, and then we can check if these readings are correct. Now comparing for the length of suspension 0.36, the value of K changes when the beam is loaded, and similar is the case for 0.56. So in 0.36, you can see three readings are marked in three different shades of orange: 0.14, 0.14 and 0.12. Similarly, for length of suspension 0.56, we have these values at 0.15, 0.13 and 0.15. So the value of K changes when the mass is loaded. So you can add that to conclusion. We can also observe that at the value of A, 0.079, the value of K remains nearly same. That is, if A is same, L does not affect the value of K. You see this? 0.14 and 0.13 in both the cases. And in for length of suspension 0.56, we have 0.13 and 0.15. You can see all of them in the color scheme. I have tried to maintain that. So we have verified the equation and found out the radius of gyration of the body in different cases. Talking about the last case, that is A equals to 0.158, we need to perform the experiment again. Now there's a question. What if the CG of body is not maintained at the center? That is, we add different masses on both the sides of the center point. That is, M is changed and A remains constant. Can we apply this equation and the similar equation and find the radius of gyration? That is the first question. Second question, is this the right method? And would we get k theoretical and k experimental of the same order? Please mention that in the comments.